This is your math gal, Julie Harland. Please visit my website at yourmathgal.com, where all of my videos are organized by topic. All right, on this video, we're going to find the average rate of a trip where there's two parts. And what I mean by that, you're going at a different rate at different times during the trip. So remember the formula, rate times time equals distance. And from this formula, we can say that means the rate would be the distance over the time, and we could say the time is the distance over the rate. So here's our problem. Tim's mom lives 120 miles from his home. He gets on the freeway and drives the first 100 miles at an average rate of 75 miles per hour, then gets on a country road for the last 20 miles, traveling at a rate of 40 miles per hour. What is his average speed for the entire trip? All right, so we could kind of put this information in a chart if we want. There's a first part of the trip and a second part of a trip, and there's a distance and a rate given for both of those. And so there, what was given is that there was 120 miles total. That was the total. And so the first part of the trip, he was going 100 miles, and his rate was 75 miles per hour. Okay? For the second part of the trip, he had 20 miles to go, and he was going 40 miles an hour. Now, it doesn't make to say a total rate. There's no such thing as a total rate. All right. What about the time? You can get the time by doing distance over rate. So for the first part of the trip, his time is 100 over 75, which can be reduced if you divide 25 into both of these numbers to 4/3. For the second part of the trip, you could do the distance over the rate as well. So it's 20 over 40, which reduces to 1/2. Divide the top and bottom by 20. And it does make sense to say what's the total time. We would have to add 4/3 plus 1/2. So let's do that. The total time is 4/3 plus 1/2. So we need a common denominator. We can multiply the first fraction by 2 over 2, second fraction by 3 over 3. And that gives us 8/6 plus 3/6, right? So hopefully you can do that in your head. 8 plus 3 is 11/6. So the total time is 11/6, or 1 5/6 hours. Now, if you wanted to know what that was in terms of hours and minutes, 1 5/6 hours, just so you have a frame of reference here, equals, that's the same thing as 1 hour and 50 minutes, okay? Because 5/6 of an hour is 50 minutes. 5/6 of 60 minutes is how you get that. So that is the total time. Okay, so now that we know the total time and we know the total distance, that was 120, we can find our average rate. So remember, rate is distance over time. All right, so for our problem, what was the total distance? That was 120. And what was the total time? Right here, 11/6, right? That's the total time. That's 11/6. Now, this is a complex fraction, so I like to write that as 120 divided by 11/6. I'm going to change colors here just so we're not running into the top. All right, which is the same thing as 120 over 1 times 6/11. And 11 doesn't cancel into anything, so you're just going to have to multiply that out. That's 720/11. So that's the rate, right? The rate is 120 divided by 11/6, which is 720/11 miles per hour. Now, you can go ahead and do long division, 720 divided by 11, right? And you could get a, you know, usually you don't say I'm going 720 elevenths miles per hour. That does sound sort of funny. So let's say you were going to do that division. So we have 11 into 720. And so it goes 6 times. And then 11 goes into 65 times. We have a remainder of 5. So it's 65 and 5 elevenths. Okay, so that's, you know, a little bit more than 65 miles per hour. And usually, now, of course, if you were going to round it, you know, that's about 65 and a half miles per hour. But I'm just going to leave it as the exact answer because that really is the average. That's the exact average right here. So that is the average rate for an entire trip. Okay, so now we want to check this, see if it makes sense. So here's the original problem. And so we got for the entire trip, we just found out the rate was 65 and 5 elevenths miles per hour, which if I'm going to change this to an improper fraction, I'm just go back to what it was originally, 720 over 11. The time was 1 5/6 hours. Before we changed that to a mixed number, it was 11 6 hours. And our distance was just 120 miles, right? I didn't have to do anything. So I'm just going to see if the rate times time really does equal the distance, right? So we're just going to check. Is it true that the rate, which is 720 elevenths, times the time? In fact, I'm going to write down what I'm doing here. I'm checking that the rate times time, okay, so 720 elevenths times 11/6, what is that going to give you? Well, the 11s cancel, right? And 6 goes into 720, 120. And so it does come up to 120. That checks with what it should have been. So that is the correct answer. And so our rate over the whole trip was right here, 65 and 5 elevenths miles per hour. And that's the average rate over the entire trip.
This is your math gal, Julie Harland. Please visit my website at yourmathgal.com, where all of my videos are organized by topic.